Hello, today I'm going to present an issue about Indomie and Gaga Noodles business competition using line chart. But before that, let me introduce myself to you. My name is Nadia Nanda Dewi Sueda from Class 2C English for Business Communication and Professional with subject English Business Communication and Ma'am Dr. Hikmah Nur Agustina as the lecturer. The reason why I choose this topic is because the news is on trending. Not only that, but also because I like eating noodles. The news is interesting because of business competition. It contains significant change, and we can compare one product to another. This video describes the latest news, data and trends from business competition between the owners of Indomie Noodles and Gaga Noodles. Since an event occurred that caused quite a drastic increase for Gaga Noodles in product sales. In the last 2 months, TikTok world was shaken by a video that tells the story origin of a group of people who came up with the first concept for Indonesian instant noodles. As it turns out, it's not your average story since it reveals the betrayal by the person who founded Indofood, the company behind the Indomie brand, who allegedly took the original idea from the person who is now behind the Gaga Noodles brand. People were quick to take sides and the majority of them choose to support Gaga Noodles. Customers are no longer satisfied with the flavor of Indomie. They despise the business practice of Indofood and the owner, and Indomie lacks a human-level connection with the consumer. This caused Gaga Noodles to experience a significant increase in August 2023. And Indomie Noodles experienced a decrease in sales. The 3-2 market share is not a short-term fluctuation but part of a sustained trend. Indomie should be concerned when they see a continuous decline rather than a temporary blip. The social media news cycle can shift relatively fast, and Gaga versus Indomie might be a mere trending topic. However, what seems to pertain is the sentiment that Indomie flavor had been lacking gradually. And what this trend is showing is how other competing brands are superior in flavor compared to Indomie. The existence of fundamental dissatisfaction among customers regarding the shortcomings of Indomie is a clear danger sign. In general, dissatisfaction can also stem from a variety of factors, including reduced product quality, poor customer service, or change in consumer values and preferences. When dissatisfaction reaches a critical point, it can encourage customers to look for alternatives. As we can see from this data, since there was competition with Gaga Noodles, but from an internal perspective, namely fraud by the owner of Indomie Noodles. Many customers are actively switching to competing brands or other products as a result of their dissatisfaction, high customer churn rates, especially when combined with customer acquisition by competitors, can quickly erode market share. The data shows a decline in sales. On August 27, it was at 86% of the 100% scale. Then on September 24, it decreased to 53%. This data also shows changing or fluctuating condition. However, we can conclude that because of the leakage of business competition, it also has an impact of the sales value of Indomie in Indonesia. Next to Gaga Noodle, the interesting narrative of Gaga Noodle can be a strong motivator for customers to switch. This shows that consumers are not only motivated by price or product features but also by emotional and psychological factor. People treated the story as if Gaga Noodle's founder was the protagonist and Indomie's founder was the antagonist. They rooted for Gaga Noodles and wanted to support the brand or product since they deemed it to be deserving after all they had gone through. Not only people are rooting for the success of Gaga Noodles' founder, but most people also express their intention to switch to Gaga Noodles. Current chatter reveals that consumers find Gaga Noodles' origin story more interesting, indicating a shift in their loyalties. This data shows that there was a significant increase on August 27 to 100%. Meanwhile, on August 20, the percentage was still at 12%. This shows that the increase in sales experienced by Gaga Noodles has almost reached 100%. So, the conclusion is, if you want to start a business, you also have to be ready to compete in a healthy manner. Never commit fraud that will harm yourself in the future. Even though the impact is only temporary, the digital footprint will last forever. Mostly, strategy is perceived as something one and done. However, gaining brand loyalty is a lifetime effort. Continuously monitor and adapt your strategies based on changing customer preferences, market trends, and competitive landscape because they will change. Maybe not in the short term, but there will be a moment when a brand needs to defend its mode of competitive advantage and continue to be agile is the best trick in navigating the dynamic market. I think that's all from my video. I apologize if there's any mistake. Thank you and have a great day.